Master Chief to be a lead character in the Halo TV show, the cable network debut officially projected, and what this all could potentially mean for the Halo Infinite release date. How's it going, everybody? It's Kevin here once again, giving you another news update when it comes to Halo related. If you want to stay up to date with any Halo information or a gameplay or anything related, make sure to tap the subscribe button, keep you up to date with anything new coming to this channel, which is going to be everything that's going to be Halo related. And if you enjoy these kind of news update videos, make sure to leave a like on this video, make sure to know that you like to see more content like this. And at the end of the video, leave a comment what your thoughts are on it. So let's get right into the information here. So IGN recently posted up an article talking about some extra details that they got from a panel at the Television Critics Association Summer Press Tour, where Showtime president and CEO David Nevins, along with Showtime's president of programming Gary Levine mentions that this show is an enormous undertaking because they have a gigantic scope for this show. They strictly said in this panel that they don't want to replicate the success of Game of Thrones, but I'm pretty sure they're gonna try to rival it and make it into a sci-fi setting. And it sounds like they're kind of putting all the pieces together right here to make it sound like this could be something going on forward, saying that Gary Levine predicts the show to have a debut airtime in 2020. So we have at least a projected air date for the first episode. Obviously, it's not gonna come for probably another 2 years, sadly, but you know, at least it's going to happen. And I will go in later on this video why I think the 2020 is going to be a very important year for Halo. Levine also confirms that the show would take place on multiple locations on foreign planets, multiple planets here. So it'd be interesting to see how they're able to capture that foreign planet feel without being like too much on set, which looks kind of fake, too much CGI, which kind of helps you lose the immersion. When questioned about the writing, they talked about the writer Kyle Killian and why they made the decision. They quote here saying, "We made a conscious decision to hire a writer not known for sci-fi and not known for big movie battles because it's already baked into the Halo franchise and we will serve that. But we also wanted to ensure that we are getting beneath the formidable armor of the Spartans and really getting inside the team drama so it felt like it belonged in Showtime." Which, if you don't know, the channel is definitely dedicated to drama shows. If you don't know who Kyle Killian is, he's known mainly for Lone Star, which actually has a 7 rating on IMDb, so not too bad, and the show Awake, which has a 7.9 rating on IMDb. He was both a writer on both of those shows, so it kind of gives me hope that this guy knows how to write at least interesting interwoven character stories to where you can probably just kind of take the same tropes but put over in a sci-fi feel and hopefully make it work out well. Now, one part that I was really hoping for on this TV show that feature Master Chief, and he is now confirmed to be in this show, but not only just in the show, he's a lead character as well. As it says, Master Chief will be a lead character in the Showtime's upcoming Halo TV series. Showtime's president of programming Gary Levine told IGN, although he won't be the only protagonist in the series, which I think is great. Like I mentioned in this my previous video talking about the Halo TV show, Master Chief alone cannot carry a TV show. It'd be an empty shell of a show with no emotions, basically, because that's what Master Chief is. The characters surrounding Master Chief kind of help boost him up to where it's something he's a notable character, but it's really about these other people involved with him that really kind of push the story along and make it something rich, deep, and exciting. Now, Levine was pressed a little bit on the involvement of Master Chief in the story, as he's a character you don't see the face. You don't see his face at all. And they asked him what kind of challenges that comes with having a character where you don't see his face. And all he replied is saying, "Is a key question and an important part of our series. That's all I'll say." So he's always want to say Master Chief is in the show and he's a lead character. That's all they're going to say about Master Chief at the show right now. Over on Twitter, Steve Downes, the voice actor for Master Chief, tweeted out saying, "Master Chief will have a huge role in Showtime's Halo series." Now, for me to see this makes me think that possibly Steve Downes will do the voice acting for Master Chief in the TV show. If so, that would be amazingly authentic to the content that we know and love when it comes to Halo, and having Steve Downes being the voice actor for it would be absolutely phenomenal. Obviously, not confirmed that he is the voice actor, but I just think that having him tweet out something about this TV show saying being excited about Chief being a main part of the show makes me think he has to be in the show. Obviously, nothing confirmed. And lastly, to wrap it all into the tight, nice little bow here for you guys, we're going to do some speculation on Halo Infinite because I feel like there's a lot of things kind of lining up here that are really making it kind of show when Halo Infinite's release date is going to happen. As we mentioned earlier, the Halo TV show is set to be released in 2020. My guess would probably be in the fall. That's when normally when shows have their new season start, or in the fall. And so then that's one thing right there. Another thing mentioning that the rumors on multiple websites and multiple sources saying that this new Xbox console that's in the works, codenamed Xbox Scarlett, is predicted to be released in 2020. So we have another major Xbox related content, Microsoft related content coming in 2020. Now, I know I'm connecting dots here that are not, you know, 100% told, but Halo being a console seller, as it always has been for the Microsoft brand and Xbox, and how we don't really know much about Halo Infinite, rumors are either 2019 or 2020 for a release for Halo Infinite. I'm thinking Xbox Scarlett, whatever that real name is going to be, you're going to be released in 2020 with Halo Infinite as a launch game, well, alongside the TV show coming out that same fall. That is just a monumental stack of hype and publicity for Halo and the Microsoft brand. And so that's why I'm thinking that, like, possibly Halo Infinite might be coming out in 2020. Sadly, yes, it will be, have to wait a little bit longer, but at least it will be have an extra time to cook in the oven to make it just right. Now, this is the part of the video where I like to read some of the comments from the previous video and kind of give you a little more in-depth answers rather than just texting, because I feel like sometimes meanings get lost in translation when you're just texting back and forth with comments. So, first comment here is from Ionix Gaming, friend of the channel here, and he asks, any idea when the patch is coming out? He's talking about the MCC patch, when that's going to be coming out. Now, 343 has said that it's coming out when MCC goes to Game Pass. So the MCC Insider updates will go to the MCC once it goes to Game Pass. There's no definitive set date when that will happen, though it does seem like the Insider programs has been kind of, you know, wrapping things up to where they're making the multiplayer work rather well, functioning much better as well on top of that. So I can imagine something maybe hopefully next month, my guess, at latest October, I would think, for a release date for this patch. Mildross here leaves a comment saying that now that the Master Chief Collection is kind of more of a game hub for Halo games, he mentions about what if, you know, since there is an empty slot, like I mentioned in a previous video, right next to Halo 4 in the intelligent install location for the Insider program. So now it makes me kind of speculate, maybe Reach, maybe some other kind of game going in right there, maybe like a beta or some form of something, I don't know. There's like just a lot of empty space for some reason right there that's not centered. And so Mildress says, like, since now it's a kind of more of a Master Chief Collection is more of a game hub, what about adding Halo 5 in that empty slot right there to make it so then if you want to play Halo, you go to that game hub location. Now, I don't think I could see Halo 5 being added to the MCC just because, well, we already have the Halo 5 game. MCC, I've kind of always felt was supposed to be kind of a bit of a swan song for classic Halo fans. And so I don't see it coming to MCC, though I do think it would be a really awesome idea to have a Halo app where you play whatever Halo game you want, you know, out of any of the franchises and any game from the franchise, I should say, including Halo Infinite. I think this would be a great way to hopefully spread the population a little bit for, you know, some of the older Halos to get those kind of more lively, more played, and also kind of have people play exactly what they want. And if you, you know, involve that intelligent install as well, I think it would help keep the community as a whole much more alive, because right now the MCC is kind of low in population, and also it's also rather fragmented between the games as well. Yeah, people are very, you know, dedicated to their specific version of Halo that they like to play, be it 1, 2, 3, or 4, 5, or ODST even, and some people even really like Reach. And so if you have like a hub for that whole location, I think it would help boost the population on those less, those older games. Well, I still think that the newest game will still have the highest population because people want to play the newest Halo game. which would also kind of help lead to, I would hope to like to see Halo be more of a game of a service kind of thing rather than releasing a game every 3, 4, potentially 5 years with this cycle, just because I'd like to see at least like a Halo game be released, and you know that not, the next Halo game is not going to be released for another 5 years at the soonest, and that, you know, the games are modular enough to where you can modify how you like, and they can be updated as soon as it needs to be updated, just so then that the studio doesn't have so much pressure on creating a new game every time. I mean, look at a game like Counter-Strike. Counter-Strike is some of the most populated and most popular shooters out there, and that game came out back in what, like 2013 or something like that, still hugely popular, and it's just because it's a game for a service. You know, if you're not going to change the core mechanics of the game, why release a brand new game when you just put an update out? A little long-winded, a little off topic on that one, but I think it's like an interesting thing to bring up. Might even take a whole video to talk about that one. And lastly, King Ming leaves a comment saying, "Stop showing your face." I can't believe this comment also even got 5 likes as well. People just don't like seeing my face, apparently. I just like this style of video editing. One, kind of, I feel like watching gameplay is just a little redundant, and it kind of mixes up, adds me into the content as well. So you're coming to me to see the channel for me talk about Halo and stuff like that, rather than hearing news about Halo. You're hearing me giving you the news, so you know that you can get this facial recognition, so you can put a face to the voice and things like that. And also, I'm not the flashiest Halo player. I do good sometimes, and so I do, you know, I post up the clips that I get while playing Halo rather than entire gameplays, because I find entire gameplays honestly to be kind of boring. Clips are much more entertaining to watch, especially for these kind of formatted videos that I like to make. So the face is going to stay. But anyways guys, thank you so much for watching. I greatly appreciate it. If you enjoyed this video, please make sure to tap that like button. Let me know you want to see some more content like this. Let me know what you thought about the video, and if you think, what your thoughts about the Halo TV show. Are you excited for it? Because the more I'm reading into it, the more I'm hearing about it, the more excited I'm getting. I cannot wait till the show is actually released. And if you're new to the channel and want to stay up to date with anything Halo related, make sure to tap the subscribe with the bell for notifications, let you know every time we upload anything awesome to the channel, which is going to be every time. Check out the videos on the screen right now if you have missed anything. I'll catch you all in the next video. Peace out.